We are discussing chapter number 15, which is waves. We are going to discuss about waves. What is a wave? Any vibratory disturbance in a medium that is carrying energy from one point, say this point, to another point, without any actual movement of the medium. The medium is not moving, only the energy is passed on by the medium particles. So this is a generation of wave. You can say there are three types of waves: mechanical wave, electromagnetic wave, and matter wave. As the name is suggesting, mechanics, so this wave, these wave, they follow Newton law of mechanics and Newton law of motion. These waves, they require material medium for their propagation, which are called as mechanical wave, like the sound waves, water waves. Electromagnetic waves, or we also call them as EM waves, produced because of the electromagnetic, you can say, the phenomena and criteria. And these waves, they do not require any material medium for their propagation. These are called electromagnetic waves, like the light waves, the radio waves. Then matter wave, we know matter, which can exist in solid, liquid, gas, any body, anything which is called as a matter. So these waves are commonly used in modern technology. They are unfamiliar to us, and you will find it associated, or people generally say it is associated with the inner part of the constituents, like the electron, proton, fundamental particles basically. What are the nature of waves? We have transverse wave, longitudinal wave. So a wave which is transverse wave, in which the particles, they vibrate at right angles to the direction of propagation. So this is the direction of propagation, and this is the you can say the movement, or the lateral movement with respect to the propagation. So the particle, they move right angle to the direction of propagation. These are called as transverse wave. This is an example, a crust and troughs. You can see the upper part is crest and the lower, the ditch part, is the trough. So these waves travel in the form of crest and troughs. Then we have longitudinal wave. What are longitudinal wave? A wave in which the particle of the movement, the medium, vibrate in the same direction. That means the particle also vibrate in the similar direction in which the wave are going to vibrate, or wave are going to travel or propagate. So this is called longitudinal wave. As you see here, this is a spring. So this is a compression. The spring are, you know, they are very close to each other, and they are far apart as with respect to this. So these are rarefaction. So longitudinal waves, they form rarefaction and compression, and the transfer wave, they form crest and troughs. So this longitudinal wave, they travel in the form of compressions and rarefactions. There are various important terms which are related with the wave motion. First is the wavelength, which is represented by lambda. And this is nothing but the nearest difference, or two nearest points in which a wave have the same phase. You can say the difference, or the distance between two crests, two troughs, two crests and two troughs, and two nodes, two antinodes, all these are wavelength. Then we have time period, that is the time taken to complete one vibration. This is called as time period. If you take 1 by t, it becomes frequency. So frequency is the number of vibration completed in 1 second, which is actually the inversion of this time period. So frequency is given by 1 by t, 1 by time period. The SI unit of this frequency is hertz, H-E-R-T-H, T-Z, hertz. Now the velocity, or wave velocity, we can write it as V. So the distance traveled by a wave in 1 second, the distance traveled by a wave in 1 second is called the velocity of the wave. And there is a relationship between the velocity, frequency and wavelength, that is V equal to F lambda. Velocity is equal to frequency into wavelength. Frequency can be written as nu also. You will see in the book, it will be written in the form of nu. Because V and nu matches so much, that is why we have written F here. What is the particle velocity? Particle velocity, the velocity of the particle, which is actually moving here and there, that is moving at the same position of vibrating. You can say simple harmonic motion it is doing. This is called the particle velocity. This is given by dy by dt. Sound waves, of these mechanical waves, all the mechanical waves occurs in nature. So the most important is the longitudinal wave in medium. Usually the air we see, these are called the sound waves. So this is one of the kind of mechanical waves. So there are three types basically: infrasonic, audible and ultrasonic. So let us have a range from 0 to 20 hertz, 20 to 20,000 hertz, and then 20,000 hertz and above. So 0 to 20, if the frequency is here, we call them as infrasonic waves. From 20 to 20,000, that is 20 kilohertz. We also, the audible range of human being is 20 hertz to 20k, that is 20,000 hertz, and these are called as audible waves. When we go above this 20 kilohertz, these are known as ultrasonic waves. The waves which has frequency higher than 20,000 hertz or 20 kilohertz, these are ultrasonic waves. So sound waves, as we said, that these are mechanical longitudinal waves, so they travel in rarefactions and compression. They require medium for their propagation, and sound wave cannot propagate through vacuum. If we have Vs, the speed of sound waves in solid, Vi in liquid, and Vg in gases, you can also write it as L. So this is the relationship that sound waves, they are traveling faster in solid, then liquid, then in the last in gas. The sound waves, that is longitudinal wave, they can reflect, they can refract, they can interfere, and they can diffract as well, but they cannot be polarized, because only transverse wave like this can be polarized. Velocity of longitudinal wave is given by V equal to under root E by rho in any medium. This E is the elasticity of the medium, and this rho is the density of that medium. So this is the velocity of longitudinal waves. Newton formula. According to Newton, the propagation of this longitudinal wave in gas is an isothermal. Isothermal means temperature remaining constant. Isothermal process. So the velocity of longitudinal wave or a sound wave in gas would be V equal to under root ET by rho. And what is this? This is P. ET, why we are writing E sub T? Because of the isothermal. So this ET is the isothermal coefficient of volume elasticity, and this is equal to the pressure. So ET, isothermal elasticity, equal to the pressure of the gas. Then we have Laplace correction. Laplace said that the propagation of longitudinal wave is an adiabatic process. That is, the pressure should be constant. So the velocity of longitudinal sound wave in gas should be ES, that is gamma P by rho. This ES is the adiabatic coefficient of the volume elasticity, and this is given by ES is given by gamma P. P is of course the pressure. What are the factors which are affecting velocity of longitudinal or sound wave? First is the effect of pressure. So the formula we know, the velocity of sound in a gas V is given by under root P by rho. And we know PV equal to RT if the number of moles are 1. For 1 mole PV equal to RT. So for this P, we can write RT by M, RT by V. And when we put it here, the V and rho will make M. We know that mass is equal to this volume into density. So volume and density makes M. So this formula becomes under root RT by M. So this P by rho remains constant at constant temperature. If this T is constant, the mass will remain constant, and R is the universal gas constant. So this P by rho remains constant at constant temperature. This has to be constant. Temperature has to be constant. So there is no effect of pressure on velocity of longitudinal wave. Then the effect of temperature, the velocity of longitudinal wave in a gas, again this when we talk about the gas or you can say effect of temperature, when with respect to velocity of longitudinal wave in a gas, we say V equal to under root gamma P by rho. Again this P can be This P can be written as RT by V, and RT by V, V and rho makes mass, so RT by M. So you see, velocity is directly proportional to under root of T because R and M are constant. So you can say V is directly proportional to the under root of the temperature. So you can write V1 by V2 equal to under root T1 by T2 equal to, you know, you can carry on with various velocity with respect to temperature. So velocity of sound is in gas is directly proportional to the square of its absolute temperature, that is the temperature at Kelvin scale. So if V0 and Vt, these are velocity of air at say 0 degree centigrade and T degree centigrade. So Vt becomes V0 1 plus T by 273 to the power half, that is root, under root. And we need to solve this, taking this half into consideration, a root into consideration. Vt is equal to V0 plus 0.61 T. We can also do it by the expansion of Mylovil theorem. What is the effect of density? The velocity of sound in gaseous medium V is inversely proportional to the under root of density. So we can write V1 by V2. So rho 1 goes here, V2 for V2, rho 2 goes here. When V2 are velocity, rho 1, rho 2 are the density. So velocity of sound in gas is inversely proportional to the square root of the density. Inversely proportional to square root of density. And the effect of humidity, the velocity of sound, it increases with increase in the humidity. Velocity will increase with increase in the humidity. Shock waves. The speed of a body in air is greater than the speed of sound. And this is also known as the supersonic speed. So such a body will leave behind very clearly seen region of disturbance, which is spread continuously on the back of it, or on the release of the gases, you can say. So such a disturbance is called a shock wave. The speed of transverse motion. Whenever we are talking about a transverse motion, if we talk about an unstretched string, this V is equal to under root T by M. This T is nothing but the tension, because we are talking about the stretched string, so there has to be some tension. And M is the mass per unit length. We also call it as mu, which is mass per unit length. How can we write this? The speed of transverse wave now in solid will be under root rho by this eta by rho. Eta is what? P is equal to under root eta by rho. Eta is what? Eta is the modulus of rigidity and rho is the density of solid. Plane progressive simple harmonic wave. What is the equation of a plane progressive simple harmonic wave? It is given by y equal to a sine 2 pi t by capital T minus x by lambda, where this y is the displacement, a is the amplitude, this lambda is the wavelength, capital T is the time period, x is the distance of particle from the origin, and this v or u is the velocity. These two are exactly equal. They are just being changed, like, you know, their formula has been changed, and they are exactly similar. Important relation related to equation of progressive wave. Wave velocity is given by the coefficient of T by coefficient of x. What if you compare the equation of wave, then we see that wave velocity is given by omega by k. This k is simply 2 by lambda. So we'll use this k, which is the wave number, you can say. It is given by 2 pi by lambda. This is called the propagation constant of wave motion. Wavelength is given by lambda, is given by 2 pi by k. T is given by 2 pi by omega, and eta is given by omega by 2 pi. So the phase of vibration in the angle of sine in equation, if you see the progressive wave equation, it is given by phi is nothing but 2 pi T by T minus x by lambda. And there is a relationship between, and you know, these all has come from equating with this relationship. And this is a relationship between the phase difference and path difference, delta phi equal to 2 pi by lambda delta x. Or you can also write, this is the phase difference and path difference relation, and this is phase difference and time difference relationship. So delta phi is given by 2 pi by lambda delta x, delta phi is given by 2 pi by t delta t. So these are two relationship. Echo, the repetition of sound which is caused by reflection of sound waves, this is called echo. You might have heard echo in your room, means a big room, like auditorium. Or you might have also encountered the echo while you are on a hill and you are sounding your name, you are echoing. So this sound persists on ear for 0.1 second. So the minimum distance from sound which is reflecting surface to hear an echo is 16.5, above which only you are able to listen to the echo. If first echo to be heard after say this first second, T1 second, the second after say some T2 second, the third echo will be heard after T1 plus T2 second. Superposition of wave. So when we have one wave, another wave, what is the final wave? There is a combination of these two or multiple. I can have one more. So combination of these waves are superposition of waves. So two or more progressive waves, they can travel simultaneously in the medium without affecting the motion of one another. So there is a resultant displacement. The resultant displacement of each particle of a medium at any instance is equal to the vector sum of the displacement produced by two waves separately. So one and the other. So what we are trying to say here is the resultant displacement of each particle will be the vector sum of displacement of this one and this one waves separately. So this is called the principle of superposition. Interference. When two waves, say we have two waves and they have same frequency, the same frequency is important, traveling in a medium simultaneously in the same direction, they are going in the same direction. So there is a principle of superposition, that means the particle will move according to the vector sum of combination of these two. So the resultant intensity at any point of the medium is different from the sum intensity of the two waves. They will be different. So at some point the intensity will be quite large with respect to other points. And at some points it will be very low, very small. And this phenomena is called the interference of waves. In interference of wave, there can be constructive interference and destructive interference. When constructive interference, that is the phase difference has to be, or between these two waves, the phase difference has to be the even multiple of n, that is 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, like this. And for destructive interference, the phase difference of two waves will be the odd multiple of pi. Odd multiple of pi here, even multiple of pi here, odd multiple of pi here. That is 2n plus 1 by 2 into pi. Like you can say this. And this is 2n pi. So the maximum amplitude here in this case, if we have two waves A and B, and the amplitude of first is A, second is B, A plus B is the maximum amplitude. In this case, the maximum, because there will be this destructive interference. So A minus B, if you subtract this is the difference of component of amplitude, and this is your minimum amplitude. The intensity here is directly proportional to amplitude square. In this case also, the amplitude is given by A plus B, so A plus B whole square. In this case, A minus B amplitude, so A minus B whole square. Intensity is directly proportional to A minus B whole square. In this case, A plus B whole square in this case. So in general, what we see, the amplitude is given by under root A square plus B square plus 2AB cos phi. If you take the example of vibrating tuning fork, when it is rotated near ear, it will produce loud sound and a silence due to the constructive and destructive interference. Beats. So when two sounds of nearly equal frequency, this is very important, two sounds nearly equal frequency, so the frequency has to be very very close, they are produced simultaneously, then the intensity of the resultant sound produced by their in superposition, because they are very near, they are having same frequency, so they are going to be resultant sound of, because of this superposition, it will be increased and decreased alternatively with time. So there is a rise and fall of intensity, and this rise and fall of intensity of sound because of this scenario is called the beats. So the number of maxima and minima heard in 1 second is also known as beats frequency. So what is the number of beats heard per second? If you say n1 and n2, this is the difference of frequency of two waves. N1 minus n2 will be the number of beats heard per second. And the maximum amplitude will be a1 plus a2, both a, take a1 from one, a2 from the other one. So maximum amplitude will be a1 plus a2. The maximum intensity, we know that this is directly proportional to the maximum amplitude whole square. So a1 plus a2 whole square will be the maximum intensity. And for the loudness, the time interval will be 1 by n1 minus n2, 2 by n minus n2, 3 by n1 minus n2, and likewise. Stationary or standing waves. So when There are two similar waves. They propagate in bounded medium. Bounded medium means the boundaries are there. There is no open-ended version. They are in opposite directions, like this. Then because of the superposition, there will be a new type of wave which will be formed. And that will be appearing stationary. The name is stationary or standing. So it appears stationary in the medium. And these waves, they are known as stationary or standing waves. What is the equation of stationary wave? It is given by y equal to 2a sine 2 pi small t by capital T cos 2 pi x by lambda. So any wave, if you see sine and cos terms or like these terms, then you can say that these are stationary or standing waves. Then in stationary waves, you will find nodes and antinodes. These are obtained alternatively. This is the node and this is an antinode. What is a node? Node. This point is node, this point is node, this point is node. And this, the displacement of particle, this remains minimum. The strain is maximum. As you see, there is no movement. The strain is maximum and the pressure and density variations, these are maximum at this place. When we talk about antinodes, that is these points, the displacement of the particle, they remain maximum. It remains maximum. Strain is minimum. Pressure and density variation, these are minimum. And these distance between two consecutive nodes, that means this one, or this one, it is from here, it is lambda by 2. Lambda by 2. And the distance between a node and adjoining antinode, that is, say, this one on this one, it will be lambda by 4. And all the particles between these two nodes, they vibrate in same phase. Particle on two sides of a node, they vibrate in opposite phase. So this is the expression for n consecutive nodes, which are separated by n. It is given by this expression. You are going to use this lambda here. Wavelength. Vibration in a stretched string. So the velocity of transverse wave in a stretched string is given by like this. So when it is being stretched, so there, of course, there will be a tension. And this is N1. See, there is only we'll talk about the harmonics, etc., just now, or overtones, etc. But as you see here, there are two nodes and one antinode. Here are three nodes and two antinodes. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4 nodes and 1, 2, 3 antinodes. So this V is given by under root T by M. This T is the tension on the string, and M is, of course, the mass per unit length of the string, and this is sometimes written as mu also. So what is the fundamental frequency? As I was telling, that there are certain figures, so we start with this one. So what is the fundamental frequency, or you can say first harmonic? This is N1 given by V by 2L. And what is V? Under root T by M. Someone or some people or some books also follow this mu symbol for this. So frequency of first overtone or second harmonic will be the twice of this one, which is twice of this N1, because this is, of course, 2 into N1. And similarly, the frequency of second overtone or third harmonic will be N3, which is thrice of this one. That is thrice of N1. And you can say these N1, N2 and N3, they are relation, or they are related with 1:2:3, like this. Organ pipes. Organ pipes are cylindrical pipes, which are used to produce musical sounds, longitudinal sounds. So organ pipes are of two types. Open organ and closed. Open means they are open from both the end, that is the cylindrical pipes, they are open at both ends. Closed means they are closed at one end. What is the fundamental note here? It is the sound of the lowest frequency. See, fundamental note is related to the lowest frequency produced on in a fundamental note. That is the vibration of a system. Then we have overtones. So overtones are what? Tones, they are having frequency which are greater than the basic note. These are called as overtones. And how about harmonics? When the frequency of this overtone, they are integral multiple of the fundamental, then we call them as a harmonics. So they have to be integral multiple of the fundamental. So the lowest frequency is called fundamental note or first harmonic. Lowest frequency is fundamental note. So fundamental note and first harmonic are equal. And the second, that is the 2N, this is N and this is equal to N. And when we talk about 2N, this is what? This is the second harmonic and first overtone. So these are the vibration in open organ pipe. These two ends are open. So wherever there is opening, there will always be an antinode. And whenever there is a closing, there will be a node there. So here we will have open. So these are two ND nodes. What is the fundamental frequency of the first harmonic here? N1 given by 2V by L. N2 is given by 2V by 2L. Here it is given by 3V by 2L. So again it is N1, 2N1 and 3N1 and they are related like this. 1 is to 2 is to 3. So even in odd harmonics, they are produced by open organ pipe. When we talk about closed organ pipe, so in the closed point or the end where it is closed, there will always be a node, not antinode. Antinode will be in the opening. So the fundamental frequency or frequency of first harmonic is given by V by 4L. Here it is given by 5V by 4L. Here it is given by this is third harmonic. The second harmonic, third harmonic, fifth harmonic, it goes like this. The first is like this, third is 5V by 4L, second is like this one. So this is the variation here. N1, this is N1, this is N2, and this is N3. So it goes like this. N1, N2, N3 goes like 1 is to 3 is to 5. So this is, see, this is the third one. So we are talking about the 5N1, which is this one. When we are talking about this is, this is second harmonic, or you can say when second harmonic goes, it three, it, this is 3V by 2L, that is 3N1. So we are talking about this. So 1 is to 3 is to 5, N1 is to N2 is to N3. As you see here also, lambda 1 by 4, C lambda by 4, 5 lambda by 4. So 1, 3, 5, this is related like this. So only if you see that harmonic or the low tones, so only the even harmonics are produced by a closed organ pipe. And correction, antinode, they are not obtained exactly. If you see this antinode, if it is forming, it is not forming exactly on open end but slightly above it. So there is a difference here. This is E. The distance between the open and antinode is called the end correction. This is known as E. So the effective length of, now this is E, this is E, effective length of open organ pipe will be plus 2E. Effective length of closed will be E. So when we talk about open one, we say this is the case. So we have to add E from here, E from here. So 2E will be added. In this case, only 1E will be added. So if R is the radius of organ pipe, it will be E equal to 0.6R. What are the factors which are affecting the frequency of pipe? The length of air column. So N is inversely proportional to 1 by L. N is directly proportional, or you can say inversely proportional to 1. R, radius of air column, the temperature also, N is directly proportional to under root T. The pressure is also directly proportional, N is directly proportional. To density, it is inversely proportional. To velocity, it is directly proportional. Resonance tube. So resonance tube is a closed, see, this is a closed organ pipe. And in the length of air, this can be changed, or could be changed by changing the height. See, the height is here. From this point to this point, now the height has been changed. So it can be changed by changing the liquid column. This liquid column can be changed. Liquid column is here. So the first harmonic here, if you see the lambda by 4 is L1 plus E. For this, this is 3 lambda by 4, which is equal to L2 plus E. And the velocity of sound is equal to N lambda, which is given by 2N, L2 minus N, L1. So E can be found out using L2 minus 3L1 by 2. There was Melday's experiment. In Melday's experiment, in a longitudinal mode, the vibration of prongs of tuning fork are the length of the string. So when we talk about the frequency of vibration of string, it will be frequency of tuning fork divided by 2. This NL is given by P by L under root T by M. When we talk about this transverse wave, this was for longitudinal mode. This is for transverse mode. So for transverse mode, the vibration of tuning fork are at 90 degree to the length of the string. So now here the frequency of vibration of string will be, the frequency of tuning fork will be P by 2L under root T by M. So this is simply NL by 2. NL by 2. So in both the modes of vibration, the Melday's law says that P to the power 2 T equal to constant is obeyed. And this is the Melday's law. What are the characteristics of musical sound? There are three characteristics mainly: intensity or loudness, pitch or frequency, the quality or the timbre. What is the intensity? Intensity of this sound is energy transmitted per second
per unit area by the sound wave. So this SI unit is watt per meter square. Intensity is measured in decibel dB. The pitch and frequency, the pitch of sound is directly proportional to the frequency. A shrill and a sharp sound, this has higher pitch, and a grave and dull sound has a lower pitch. In human beings, men have their dull or lower pitch. The women and the kids, they have sharp or shrill sound. Quality and timbre. The quality is the characteristic of sound that differentiates between two sounds of same intensity and same frequency. If two brothers are talking and they are say you cannot differentiate. The only way to differentiate is to understand the quality and timbre of their sound, so that you say A is talking and B is talking. When is A talking? When is B talking? So this quality depends on harmonics and also their relative order and intensity. Doppler's effect. There is an apparent change in frequency. That is the phenomena of apparent change in frequency of source because of the relative, if we have a source and we have an observer. So because of the relative motion or movement of these two, there is a change in the frequency as being observed. And this is called the Doppler effect. So again, the phenomena of apparent change in frequency of source due to relative motion between the observer and the source is known as the Doppler effect. So when we say that this source is moving, an observer is at rest. When source is moving with say velocity towards an observer which is at rest, the apparent frequency will be n dash will be equal to nv by v minus vs. So this is source, this is observer. Source is moving and observer is at rest. If source is moving, then this minus will become plus, so away from the observer. Now source is not moving here, but source is moving on the opposite direction. This will be n dash will be equal to n v by v plus vs. There is another scenario when the source is at rest. Now the source is at rest and now the observer is moving. So when the observer is moving with say velocity vo towards a source which is at rest. Now this is at rest. The apparent frequency n dash will be equal to n v plus v0 by v. And when the observer is moving away from, means observer is not moving here, opposite direction. So n dash will be given by n v minus v0 by v. When source and observer, they both are moving, means source and observer both are moving, and when both are moving in the same direction, that means in the same direction, along the direction of propagation of sound. So this is the sound, this V is the sound, and this is the Vs and Ve movement. So this is all are going in the same direction. So the n dash will be equal to n V minus Vo by V minus Vs. So when both are moving in same direction, opposite to the direction of propagation of sound, they are moving here, observer and source, but the sound is going this side. So n dash will be equal to n v plus vo by v plus vs. When both are moving towards each other, source is coming here and o is coming in the direction which is opposite to the source, observer is coming opposite direction, and in this case the n dash will be equal to n v plus vo by v minus vs. But when both are moving in opposite direction, this is going this side, this is going this side, away from each other, then n dash will be equal to n v minus vo by v plus vs. This is Doppler effect. There is transverse Doppler effect also. The Doppler effect in sound not only takes place in the one direction, there are certain other direction also in which it happens. So the first is, you should know that Doppler effect in sound does not take place in transverse direction. That means if it is, you have here and this is moving in this direction, okay? The observer source, there will be no Doppler effect. As you see here, the position of the source, this one, and the observer is here. The component of velocity of source towards the observer, that is, this is V. What will this will be? If this is theta, this will be V cos theta. This is the, you can say, component or position of, or component of velocity of source towards the observer. This is V cos theta. And in this situation, the approach frequency will be what? We just have to take V as V cos theta in the previous discussions. So F dash will be equal to V by V minus, in this place we have to write as just Vs cos theta into F. So this F dash, which will now be the function of cos theta. So it will not be constant. It depends on theta now. Now if the source is moving, see if source is now moving on moving away from the observer. Observer is here, source is moving in this direction, opposite. So the component will be what? This is V. So the component will be, this is theta. So the component will be V cos theta. but in this direction. So this minus will become plus. So this will be V by V plus V plus cos theta into F. This direction, right? So if theta is 90, just put theta equal to 90, this becomes what? 0. So when it becomes 0, V by V, this cancels out. So F dash becomes equal to F. This is exactly what we started. That in Doppler effect, the sound does not take place in the transverse direction. So at point P, at this space, which is a transverse direction, the Doppler effect does not occur. There is effect of wind. You have to add and subtract the effect of wind. If wind is also blowing with a velocity, say this W here, in the direction of sound, then its velocity is added. See, we are adding with V. This is added. This is added. So the condition of the apparent frequency just changes with respect to this W. We just have to add this wind with the velocity. What are the applications of Doppler effect? The measurement of Doppler shift is used widely by police to check overspeeding vehicle, at airports to guide the aircraft, to study heartbeats and blood flow in different parts of the body, by astrophysists to measure the velocities of planets and stars. So let us summarize. The mechanical waves can exist in material media. These are governed by Newton's laws. Transverse waves, these are waves in which particle of the medium, they oscillate perpendicular to the direction of wave motion. So if the direction is like this, they oscillate like this. In longitudinal wave, these are waves in which the particle of medium oscillate along the direction of wave propagation. So this is the direction of propagation. The particle will also oscillate like this. The progressive wave is a wave that moves from one point to another or medium to another. The displacement in a sinusoidal wave propagating in the positive x direction is given by yx, t, a sine kx minus omega t plus phi. A is the amplitude, k is the wave number, omega is the angular frequency. And this whole is the phase, this phi is the phase angle, or you can call it as a phase constant. The wavelength lambda of a progressive wave is what? It is the distance between two consecutive points of the same phase. Phi has to be, this phase has to be equal. In stationary wave, it is twice the distance between the two consecutive nodes or antinodes. You can say crest and trough, two consecutive crest distances, the wavelength. Two consecutive trough distances, wavelength. So this period T of oscillation of a wave is defined as what? A time, as a time by any element of the medium takes to move through one complete oscillation, this T. It is related with the angular velocity like this, t equal to 2 pi by omega. The frequency of a wave is defined by 1 by t, which is actually the inversion of the previous one. So it is related to angular frequency, or you can say simply f is equal to 1 by t. What is f? Omega by 2 pi. The speed of transverse wave on a stretched string is set by the properties of the string. The speed on a string with tension T and linear mass density mu is given by V equal to under root T by mu. The sound waves are longitudinal waves that can travel through solids, liquids and gas. So the speed of, or say V speed of sound waves in a fluid, which is having B as the bulk modulus and D this rho as the density, V is given by under root B by rho. The speed of longitudinal waves in metallic bar, we have to use V is Y, Young modulus of elasticity by rho. When we talk about gases, the B is given by gamma P. This is P is pressure. And this is coefficient of the elasticity here. The speed of sound is given by V equal to under root gamma rho by gamma P by rho. When two or more waves traverse in the same medium, the displacement of any element of that medium is the algebraic sum of displacement due to each wave. So this is known as the principle of superposition. So they add up. If phi equal to 0, or integral multiple of 2 pi, the waves are exactly in phase and the interference is constructive. But if phi is equal to pi, these are exactly out of phase and the interference will be destructive. So a traveling wave at a rigid boundary or a closed end is reflected with a phase reversal, but the reflection at open boundary displaces phase without any phase change. If we have an incident wave, say yi, I is represented by incident. It is given by a sine kx minus omega t. For a reflected yr at a rigid boundary, this is minus a sine kx plus omega t. And when we have an open boundary, see this is a rigid boundary. When we have an open boundary, this yr is given by a sine kx plus omega t. So this is when they are reflected by rigid boundary or open boundary, the difference is a minus sign comes here. The interference of two identical waves moving in opposite direction, they will produce stationary or standing waves. For a string with say with fixed end, the standing wave will be given by y x comma t is 2a sine k cos omega t. So these standing waves, these are characterized, how they are characterized by fixed location of zero displacement, these are called nodes, and fixed location of maximum displacement, which are called antinodes. What is the separation between two consecutive nodes or antinode? Is lambda by 2. So the stretched string of say L fixed at both the ends, they vibrate with frequency, which is given by V equal to half V by 2L. N is of course 1, 2, 3, it varies like this. So the set of frequency given by this relation, these are called normal modes of oscillation. The oscillation mode with lowest frequency is called fundamental mode or first harmonic. The second harmonic in the oscillation mode is N equal to 2, and it goes like that. A string of length L fixed at both ends, or say an air column closed at one end and open at other end, it vibrates with a frequency called as normal modes. And each of these frequencies are known as resonant frequency. Resonant frequency. What is beat? See V1 minus V2. What is this? These are amplitudes. So the beat arises when two waves having slightly different frequencies, this V1 and V2, these are here the frequencies. And these frequencies, these two waves have comparable amplitudes and they are superimposed. So the beat frequency is given by VBT equal to V1 minus V2. These V1 and V2 are the frequencies and there are minor differences between these frequencies. The Doppler effect is the apparent change in the observed frequency of a wave when the source and observer, they are moving, they are in motion with relative to each other. For sound, the observed frequency, this is given in terms of source frequency, that is this VO. This V is the speed of sound through the medium, and VO, this is the velocity of observer relative to the medium. Vs here is the source velocity related to the medium. So if you use this formula, velocity of the direction over should be treated as positive and those opposite should be taken as negative here, negative sign. Wavelength by lambda, given by lambda, this is the distance between two consecutive points with the same phase. Propagation constant k, which is k equal to 2 pi by lambda. Wave speed v equal to nu lambda, this is frequency here. A beat frequency is the beat difference of two close frequencies V1 minus V2 of the superimposing waves. So this is all about the discussion of this chapter. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.